To Radical Toys, guys. Welcome back, gang. This week we are going to look at some Halloween props and some Halloween stuff since we got to get in the spirit, right? And of course, this is going to start out with the PKA meter. This is by Rubies. We're going to have a lot of Ghostbuster stuff coming in through it this week, or a few things, I should say, because I want to be a Ghostbuster. I've never been a Ghostbuster for Halloween, and I decided, you know what? There's only two costumes I've always wanted. One was a Ghostbuster. And the other one was a Stormtrooper. Ghostbuster is the cheaper route by far. All thanks to Rubies and, of course, Spirit Halloween. So we're going to have some good props coming in. So let's go ahead. Let's just dive right into this PKA meter and see what's going on here. Let's take a look at the package first. As we take a look here, we've got our Ghostbusters No Ghost logo. We've got a cool, what looks like the khaki in the background, so that's kind of cool with the zipper. And we got our Ghostbusters PKA meter logo going on here. Ages 14 and up. We look down at it there, you can see that it's showcased on the cardboard there. It's pretty basic simple, it's only together with a couple of straps. It's got a try me button, press button it says. We look at the other side, light, sounds, and motion. And of course, Imagine by Rubies in the bottom left. On the bottom right, requires two AAA batteries. And of course, it says that there's batteries included, but mine was left on because the batteries that were left in there, somebody had left it on. Thanks a lot, whoever did that. And yeah, so that's what it is. It is what it is. But anyway, we're going to slip this right out of the package. It's very simple. You just pull it right out. Comes right off. Look at that. It's so simple. And of course, behind it, it says it's got some instructions here. So we won't go over these because it's basically standard. It's exactly what I've just went over. It just takes batteries. And let's take a peek at the back of the cardboard. Look at this guy. He just looks like a bull. I think this is hilarious. This guy just isn't selling it for me. It looks like he's not even trying. So, yeah, I'm not buying it, bud. And, yeah, so anyway, we just got the light, sound, and motion again. PKA meter at the top. We look on down. We got a bunch of mumbo jumbo we don't really care about. Ghostbusters logo going on there. And, of course, our barcode. Fun stuff. There's our package. Let's go ahead and look at the PKA meter itself. So, I mean, it looks pretty good. Now, the first thing you're going to notice right off the bat is mine looks like it's got some weathered looks on it. And it does, because I did it. I customized this before I even did the review. Basically, when you get this, it'll look just like this, except for you won't get the paint on it. Basically, what I did was I just took a dry brush, silver, and I just did some of my own weather effects. Looks like, basically, make it look like it's steel underneath sort of deal. So it looks like it's been through the ringer and back, and I just like that. That's kind of the look that I want to go for. Especially, like, you know, with the proton pack and stuff, too, I'll probably be doing the same thing. You can kind of see at the bottom there. Starting to come off. I might have to, you know, do a prime and stuff on it. I just basically just took a brush to it. I didn't do any primes or anything like that. So if it comes off, I can always just do it again. No big deal. But anyway, it's got your standard green screen here. And of course, you got all these lights. These are going to light up, by the way. You got two red ones down there. And of course, you got a try me button. And of course, you got the longer version button there. So that's kind of cool. And as you look on down, you can see that you indeed have a switch for the on and off. It's off right at the moment. And of course, this has a clip on it. Now, this isn't exactly screen accurate. I know this, in the movie that this clip wasn't here, but for a casual Ghostbusters fan like myself, this is perfectly fine. I absolutely love this. It's very lightweight. There's not a whole lot of weight to it. Very, very light. So if you have it on your belt, like if you got your if you got a pistol belt, it's not going to really bother you or get any way. It shouldn't. And I do have some more Ghostbuster stuff coming. So as they come in, we'll check that out. We'll put it together sort of thing. This is just kind of the first piece that I got. And yeah, so on the sides here, we've got a bunch of LED lights. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on each side respectively. So they will light up when you turn it on. That's kind of cool. Got two screws here. Now, if you really wanted to, you could probably open this casing up and cover them up with putty or whatever you want to do, or from the inside. If you want to get more accurate with it, it's up to you. But like I said, I'm just a casual Ghostbusters fan. I always wanted a Ghostbusters outfit, but I'm not going to be particularly fussy when it comes to being screen accurate. And of course, let's go ahead. We want to try this out. We want to see what this looks like, and we want to see what it sounds like, because yeah, it's motion, or it's got motion and it's sound activated. So you turn on, and we'll go ahead and we'll do the try it first. So here's the try. You can kind of see the lights are lighting up. It's kind of cool. And then we'll do the longer version. So if you press this one, I don't know how long it goes, but it goes pretty long. And you can kind of see the light that lights up on the screen too. It looks pretty cool. I like this. This is pretty neat. I wish the sound could be a little bit better. Gonna get some ghosts. This is kind of cool. Yeah, I like this. The only thing I would say, wow, this is actually going on quite long. I do like that it lights up yellow, just like it did in the movie, so that's kind of cool. See the red lights. Let me flick out the lights for a minute and we'll check this out. Yes, sir. That's pretty cool, guys. I like that. I'd love to be walking around in the dark like that with that on. That's actually pretty cool. It's pretty snazzy. I guess it doesn't stop until you actually hit the button and press it again. Like, press the button in again to get it to stop. I guess it just continuously goes. So that's kind of neat. That's kind of interesting. But yeah, that's the PKA meter. It's actually a little bigger than I expected it to be, but not too big. It's just, I was expecting it to be smaller, like kid size or something like that. But no, this is definitely adult size. It's probably a little bit bigger than the actual one in the movie. I would say it's probably just a tad bigger, but not overly huge. It's a great prop for a budget. I believe Canadian, this was $29.99 Canadian, so it's not too bad. It came from Amazon. This was sent in from my brother, so that's awesome that he sent this in for me. They were trying to get my costume together, so this is kind of cool. So yeah, it's not a bad little prop. I like it. You know, what do you guys think of these little props and stuff? Like, it's for an affordable price. I mean, I know the Maddie Collector one's extremely expensive. And yeah, so it was out of my grasp that I'd want to pay for. But this, I didn't mind. And yeah, so you can get they got one on Spirit Halloween's one as well. Spirit Halloween has one. Ruby's has got one, so you can get them on Amazon. So get them while you can. If they're not already sold out. I don't think they are. I think they're still available. They should be. But yeah, it's pretty cool. But that's pretty much a wrap for this one, guys. I just want to do a quick review on the PKA meter for Ghostbusters prop. More coming up this week. And, stay tuned for more stuff this week, as I get some more Ghostbuster stuff coming. So hopefully you like it. And yeah, so we'll see you on the next one. And you guys have a good one. Have a good night. And take care, guys. Bye-bye.